That, of course, was Oscar De La Hoya's reaction to Jaime Munguia's win, an impressive win over John Ryder, and now Munguia's 43-0. One person to visit Munguia backstage in the locker room was Eric Morales, his former coach, and now a future politician in Mexico. And Eric is also a boxing icon in his own right, a Hall of Famer, and a very nice person that. So it's nice that he came to show support for his former fighter. A lot of fighters came to visit Munguia today in the locker room. You'll see one of them after the other. Here's Amir Khan, I think, was after Eric Morales. Of course, there's Amir. After Amir, you also had other fighters like Rafa Espinosa, and you'll see in the video Gabe Rosado visiting him. So there's Amir Khan, all the way from England. He came to support to watch this fight of John Ryder against Jaime Munguia. They're talking about the hand wraps. They're watching the hand wraps. And Munguia, all business before, Amir says hi. Jaime is smiling, glad to see him, and definitely happy to be there. Of course, Jaime Munguia has a lot of big fights coming up. Amir already fought Canelo. Jaime has a potential. Maybe he fights Canelo down the line. Not sure if that happens, of course. We'll see. Canelo has two fights left with PBC. And maybe if there's a Munguia fight, that deal with PBC, now that they have Amazon Prime, that may extend. Maybe they'll do a 3-4 fight deal with Canelo. Since the two fights they have, they may want to keep for their own fighters. But there's Gabe Rosado. He bet the 9th round win for Munguia. And Munguia, guess what? Got the win in the 9th round while dropping John Ryder 4 times in the process. Rafa Espinosa, upset of the year 2023 over Rabassi. And here he is visiting Jaime Munguia. He's a very good singer, by the way. Rafa Espinosa, he was singing to his parents the other day, an original song that he sang. And here are some celebrities from Mexico. Also, that's, of course, Edwin Caz, very, very famous. And he's showing love to Jaime Munguia, talking to him backstage in the locker room before the fight. So Munguia is very popular. Here he is warming up, getting loose. He has a big team. And as you could see from the video with Oscar and B-Hop, they're very, very happy for Jaime Munguia. They love the kid. They support him. And he did his thing. He got the win. He got the stoppage. And now it's going to be very interesting to see what does Jaime Munguia do next. What's the next step for Munguia? Is it Benavidez? There was talk of Benavidez before that fight fell through. David posted right after the fight, easy knockout. This is the reason they ducked me. So David thinks it's an easy fight. That fight was supposed to happen, never matured. And now let's see what happens next. So if it's not Benavidez and it's not Canelo, does he fight Dave Morrell? That's a huge fight. That's more doable. Morrell is a monster. And he fights at 168. And there's a lot of buzz around him. And it's a possibility for Jaime Munguia. It all depends what he does next. So we'll keep you guys posted. But definitely tonight was Jaime Munguia's night. He did his thing. He got the win. He looked good. It was an entertaining fight. It wasn't just one-sided 100%. I think Munguia obviously dropped Ryder in a second, dropped Ryder in a fourth. But round, if I'm not mistaken, round 6 and 7 were John Ryder's best rounds. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. Congratulations to Munguia. He got the W. And we'll see what happens next. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.
Ellie Secback reporting. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.